Pharmacy board exams covers a wide range of topics such as pharmacology, therapeutics, pharmacy calculations, and many more. These topics require deep understanding on this subject matter and also applying this knowledge to the real world scenarios. So today I like to test some board exam style questions from the pharmacy prep question bank on ChatGPT to see how ChatGPT would respond to those complex case scenarios. And at the end, I also grade the how ChatGPT performed. Let's start. So here are the question is which I'll be testing is about the management of hypertension in adults, and which is I'll be test answer will be based on ACC and AHA and CHEP clinical guidelines. So here the question is about for a 55-year-old African-American man who was recently diagnosed with hypertension, and he has also currently is taking only omeprazole for the 8 weeks. Otherwise, he has no other chronic conditions, and also he is not taking any other medication. So after trying his lifestyle medication, his blood pressure is still high, which is 150/86. So the question is about what is the best thing to start, initiate the medication for this one. So the best answer is amlodipine 5 mg, because as per this case, the person is African-American descent. So therefore, as per the AHA guidelines, there are the best option would be calcium ion channel blockers or thiazide diuretics, because the angiotensin system has less effect in this ethnic group of the patient. So therefore, based on the ethnicity and patient age and all those conditions and no other chronic conditions, so therefore the best option would be amlodipine. So this is the first question. Now let's put this question to the test with ChatGPT to see how ChatGPT would respond to this question. So here, our answer for this question was amlodipine. Let's look at here what would be the answer in the ChatGPT. So based on this response from the ChatGPT, the patient medical history, a blood pressure reading, appropriate agent is option A, which is lisinopril. So that's unfortunately is incorrect, because as per the our previous discussion, the best answer would be the B. So that's a wrong answer according to this one. So let's mark as a 0 and 1. So for ChatGPT got 0 out of 1 answer. So let's do the next question. Here, let's start the next question. So the next question was, what is the most appropriate blood pressure goal or target for the same patient? And our answer was 140/90. So let's see what would be the answer for as per the ChatGPT. Right, so the answer is correct. So as per this ChatGPT, the answer is less than 140/90. That's the correct answer. All right, so let's try the next question. So far we have 0, 2 and 1 correct answer. You have a 1 wrong answer. So at the end we will do the final total, what would be the ChatGPT score in the test. Next question I like to test is about a patient who has chronic kidney disease and also has been diagnosed with type 2 diabetes. So this will be based on the answer, our pharmacy prep question bank answer would be based on the CODICO diabetes guidelines based on 2020. So this is the question. The question is about a patient who's a 64-year-old having history of hypertension, heart failure, and CKD. So now is experiencing symptoms of hyperglycemia, and current A1C is high, which is 7.9%. And also norm serum creatinine is not bad, which is a 50 mils per minute, which is less, but it is not very low. So what anti-diabetic drugs are the first line for the patient with type 2 diabetes? So as per this pharmacy prep answer, we are selecting here metformin plus empagliflozin, because according to the CODICO diabetes guidelines 2020, so here the best anti-hyperglycemic have shown to be renal protective plus ortho cardioprotective, or the first line therapies are metformin and then SGLT2 inhibitors. So therefore, based on this reference, so SGLT2 inhibitor was empagliflozin and then metformin, and patient still has 50 milliliters per minute creatinine clearance. So therefore, still these two drugs can be still used for this patient. So now let's put this question to the test with the ChatGPT to see how ChatGPT respond to this question. So let's test this question in ChatGPT to see what is the best answer. So here, let's look at here. All right, so our best answer was supposed to be, the best answer is empagliflozin, but as per the ChatGPT, is suggesting linagliptin or dulaglutide. So therefore, I would say a best answer is supposed to be A. So it is incorrect answer as per our database at Pharmacy Prep. So therefore, the correct answer is supposed to be A. So let's do the next question about the drug interaction questions. So in this drug interaction question, here is the case about a patient, 58-year-old. He brings a prescription for levofloxacin and for the treatment of pneumonia. And patient has arrhythmia, and the patient history include arrhythmia and currently taking amiodarone. So patient has no other conditions and also have no known allergies. So now in this situation, levofloxacin and amiodarone has a category X drug interaction according to the FDA category X, which is because both of them are known to have a higher QT prolongation side effects. So combining those two drugs can be much higher QTC prolongation, which is considered as a severe interaction. And according to the FDA category, which is a category X, that means you cannot combine those two medications. So now let's see. So let's look at this question. I'm just testing the question about MP. He's 58-year-old, comes to your pharmacy for filling this prescription. And according to this reference, just now we saw answer supposed to be the C. That is the right answer. So now let's see what does ChatGPT would show the answer for this one. All right, so here it says levofloxacin, amiodarone have a drug interaction, so recommend amoxifloxacin. So as per the reference, moxifloxacin also have a pretty good higher QT prolongation side effects. So therefore, it is an incorrect answer to select answer A. So therefore, I would categorize this as an incorrect answer according to the ChatGPT. So the next question I like to test is about a calculation, which is calculating percent strength. Well, I like to do all the different competencies that are tested in the board style exam. So therefore, I would be testing various different type of questions. So here, let's test these calculation tests. So this question will be about a pharmacist adds 12 mils of 35% of weight by volume solution onto a 500 mils of dextrose 5% water. So question would be, what would be the percent strength for the new preparation? So in this case, you have 35% means 35% is 35 grams in 100 mils. So that would be, we're not adding 100 mils, we are adding only 12 mils. So the question would be, 12 mils is how much? 12 mils would be 4.2 grams. But the question is, now you're adding this 4.2 grams to this 500 mils. So 500 mils plus 12 mils is 512. So 512 mils has 4.2 grams. So the question is for percentage strength. So that means 100 mils is how many grams? So that would be equals to 0.82 grams. That's the and select the best answer. So let's see what would be the best response. Right, so far doing good. So this is exactly the expected response, which is a 0.82 grams weight by volume percentage. So the answer is correct answer. That is 0.82 grams that is given by ChatGPT. So we accept this answer as a correct answer. So that means ChatGPT got 1 point. So next question I like to test is about vancomycin infusion calculation. So it's quite a simple calculation. Here we have 1 gram of vancomycin was added to 1 liter of normal saline. So calculate the rate of infusion of vancomycin if infusion was given 12 hours. So basically the question is asking about of 12 hours. So first thing you should calculate is you're adding to 1 liter. So 1 liter is given for 12 hours. So question answers are given per minute. So therefore you calculate that for 12 hours, 60 minutes, that would be 720 minutes. So therefore 1000 by 720 minutes, that would be equals to 1.38 mils per minute. So the correct answer is the B. So let's start the testing for this question with the vancomycin question just now I discussed. So here we have same question, less the correct answer as per this one to calculate the rate of infusion. So the answer here was 1 gram is 1 milligram per mil. So total volume, that's a correct one. So here, so far going well. So the answer is B, which is a 1.3 L. So this is a correct answer. So that means ChatGPT did a good job of doing the correct answers. So at the end, I will tell you how many total answers were correct. So for now, so far seems like a not that bad something. ChatGPT is progressing well. And let's see. Next question I like to test from pharmacokinetics. That is about calculating steady state concentration. So in this one here, we have a question about a drug administered by IV. Rate was 2 mg/kg and half-life is 1.5 hours. Volume of distribution is 150 liters. Average for a 70 kilogram patient. So question is, what is steady state concentration of the drug X in a plasma? So this is the formula, which is steady state concentration is equals rate of infusion by elimination constant and volume of distribution. So if you plug in these numbers into this, so you calculate K elimination constant, which is based on the half-life. So K elimination constant is 0.693 by 1.5 hours, so which is a half-life, which comes to be K elimination 0.46. So now once you have a K elimination constant, now you can calculate steady state concentration, which is rate of infusion is 2 mg, elimination, the constant is 0.46, and then total volume of distribution is 150 liters. So it comes to be 0.28, so that is equals to answer A. So now let's test this same question in ChatGPT to see how well ChatGPT does these answers. So let's test this steady state calculation, steady state concentration calculation for the drug X. So here is the correct answer was A. So now let's see what ChatGPT will calculate for this one. Great, so that sounds like a correct answer. So here we got A, which is 0.002 milligrams per liter. That sounds like a good, well done, correct answer for this calculation. Let's try the next different question I like to test is about the absolute risk reduction calculation. So how to calculate the absolute risk reduction. So here is the case scenario for a patient, you are critically appraising a study for a new osteoporosis medication, which examines drug ability to reduce fracture. And there are 1,000 patients in total, 500 of them are randomized as a control, and another 500 are experimental group. So basically, by using this formula, which is control event rate equals control event, and then experiment event rate, first calculate for each 1,000 divided by, 500 patients, so it comes out to be 0.20% of control event rate, and then experiment event rate is 16%. So now, based on this, so if you absolute risk reduction formula is control event rate minus experiment event rate, so it comes to be 4%. 4% is the answer. So answer B is the correct. So now let's test this calculation into the ChatGPT to see how does it give the response. Question on calculating absolute risk reduction, which is a part of the biostatistics competency. So as per calculation that just now we have seen, the answer was 4%. So now let's put this onto the test for this question with ChatGPT to see if to find what would be the right answer. Right, correct answer, so it's a 4%. So that is a correct answer by ChatGPT. So let's test the next another different competency questions to see how ChatGPT, which is a calculating retail price. So here is the question: a pharmacy has received new stock of pharmacy product ABC. Cost of these are given $15, $20, and $25. The markup is 40%. What is the total retail price for combined three products? So if you add this, so it is just total price is $60 of combined three. So markup is 40%, which is equals to 1.4. So that comes to be total price would be 84. So answer is 84. So let's put this question to the test with the ChatGPT to see how does ChatGPT does this answer. Now let's test this into the ChatGPT. So this is about calculating a retail price for three products combined with the markup of 40%. So we saw the answer was $84. So let's see how would ChatGPT do that. That's this one. Great. So answer seems to be correct answer. So it is about $84 as per our calculation, and then the pharmacy prep calculation. So therefore, that's the right go-to answer. I think that's the ChatGPT have done good job of finding the right answer so far. All right, so now total, we'll see how many answers have been correct for total all the questions. And then let's grade the ChatGPT performance for compared to pharmacy prep questions, which is a board exam style questions. And let's start looking the grades of that.